What do you need there, pal?
All right, let's get to work.
What do we have here?
The Rail of Adamant itself has found its way into your hands, cousin. A malignant thing, if you were to ask me. And not...
Fix that for you. Let me have it.
Possibilities can be tedious to choose from, so let me provide you with a significantly smaller set with which you may yet change the fates desired.
Witches. Sighted. My boon from chaos is transformed. Shiny. Much better.
The sea.
Cheers, Uncle. Not yet. The gods want me to pick a favorite.
A good decision there.
Avoided this outcome any number of ways.
Damned either way, I guess.
prefer to think we both know better than to...
Collect. Lurks in the River Styx. Mine! The knucklehead! Let's go, Exegriff. Pleasure doing business. Thunder and lightning. Not yet. That's enough Tartarus. Check. Gods.
Didn't he? All bluster muscles and bravado, that one. I'm glad you're not the type.
My heart is full. Which path? All aboard.
My mind, hon. I go through this stuff awful fast sometimes.
And I, in turn, shall go through your incredible cooking awful fast, given the opportunity.
Been trying to perfect these recipes for I don't know how long. Coming right up.
Really hit the spot.
Take care, yeah?
Hello, Witch's Circle. That takes care of them. A change of boons was in order. A relief.
Express delivered message for you, cuz. It says, congratulations, you're my 100th customer today. And here's what you get.
Going. That boon got better, huh? How's the old neck holding up? Wherever your neck went.
Short work of the Hydra, then, I take it.
Here, then. Time to pick a fight. Going in. In the name of Hades.
I've a vision I must share with you. A waking phrase for Exegryph, to be precise. Please beseech the weapon thus. I see your prideful fall down from the heavens to the flames. An odd connection to a past or future bearer, apparently one who defied a god.
I see your prideful fall down from the heavens to the flames.
Oh, but this is such a heartbreak, dearest. Why would you do that?
Lady Aphrodite, I'm sorry. Guess she's upset.
Dearest. Though, might I suggest you take some extra steps to keep it that way? Hmm?
Love and loss. Ready.
area. Want to stand back and watch me work here, Zag? You so-called champions could use a lesson in humility.
Lesson one, don't mess with either one of us.
I'm empty.
This time. That's better. Use this. Care for a rematch?
Well, worm, come fight us, I suppose, and take fullest advantage of the havoc that you sowed. We are no team. We're merely two combatants, simultaneously booked to be here now.
King, I think you're overreacting here. Try to be reasonable, and be more considerate about my point of view. Don't think I'm asking for too much.
You're asking the impossible of me! But let us fight, and let us lose, I'm sure. Because if we are not a team, what are we then, Asterius?
Thank you.
now.
God, that... you! Goddess Demeter, I beg of you, assist me!
One champion unseated. To my greatest fan. I'll just help myself.
Should be another such performance soon. Sold.
Out of here. Good. The edge of Father's realm. Try this way.
Hey!
Don't do that. Boom. Found it fast this time. Olympus, I accept this message. A special treat for Cerberus. Heading back. Now for a chat with Cerberus. Thank you, mate.
Thank you.
Galactus can get me out of here. One satyr sack for one good boy. In here. This one. God's grant me strength.
There's a solitary weakness, Satyr Sacks.
I owe you one, boy. You ready for another go?
You'll go not one step farther past this threshold, boy.
Wretches, rest in peace.
Darkness.
I can't.
Darkness.
Not yet.
Thank you. every one of my defenses once again. I'll get you yet.
There. In my father's name.
Despite having transcended past the confines of the underworld yet again, Prince Zagreus proves utterly unable to get past this point.
No!
Did pretty well that time.
That's the last of the new registrations, but I should have more soon.
Okay!
Boy. So help me, boy, I cannot fathom why you would have bought back the authority to enter the administrative chamber once again.
I knew you thought I'd never do it under any circumstances, Father. That seemed reason enough. Though fear not, I've no plans to reapply for a position there.
That does alleviate a deeply rooted fear of mine, in fact. The scene you caused in your brief time there yet remains a widely talked about event among the shades who toil for me still.
I'll be sure to say hello. Mother, you'll forgive my asking, but your mother used to call you by a different name, didn't she?
Ugh, don't remind me. Imagine if I called you Zaggy-poo from when you were born to this very moment. That's how that name felt to me. I much preferred the name my father gave to me.
Your mortal father, right? So he called you Persephone. What was he like?
He was kind to me, and funny. Little bringer of destruction I was to him. I liked that. He was right, I was a terror. But then he passed. I was very little still. My mother never spoke of him again.
Demeter mentioned him a bit to me. She seems... I don't know, but I don't sense that she regrets the relationship or anything. Just sad about the outcome, I think.
I suppose I can see that. I thought I might end up like Father, growing old, wasting away. Then the time flew by, and I realized I was closer to Mother's side. Mortals certainly don't have it easy. But their limited days, it means they live their lives to the fullest, I think.
At least we've some of that in us.
Indeed, my son. Thank you very much, my son. You know, gift-giving customs of the underworld are just so much more straightforward than the complicated social...
If there are other ways of showing one's appreciation than with nectar and the like, well, they must pale in comparison, I'm sure. Achilles, sir, you happen to know whether Father authorized the transfer of a Macedonian Tau Lambda chariot to Elysium in recent memory? I ran into the former hero Theseus all joyriding about in one of those.
I know the chariot you mean. It's not just any Macedonian. It's modified, apparently by Daedalus himself. No earthly weapons can do what it does. Though, please don't tell me Theseus put on that mask.
What, you mean the golden matching mask? I saw him wearing it all right. Looked like a proper fool, I thought. What of it, though?
Well, I think that Daedalus would certainly agree. Heard that he fashioned that mask and outfit as a little joke. For someone deeply prideful and well unaware. It must have suited Theseus quite well then, yes?
That it did, most definitely, sir.
Oh, hi! Hey, Prince, is it really true about Miss Meg and you? I mean, that you're, because if so, then I want you to know. I'm just so happy for the two of you. That's wonderful, you two. I'm so glad.
Thank you, Dusa. I know you and Miss Meg are close, so I am grateful that we have your blessings. though we're kind of not out in the open with it necessarily, so if you please, just keep it quiet for us, would you?
Oh, you better believe it. I will tell nobody whatsoever. No. I'll just be very, very happy to myself. All right, then. Bye.
Bye. How's that knife set working out? Always a pleasure. I don't suppose the name Skelly happens to mean anything to you, does it?
It means nothing to me at all, my child. Though, why do you invoke such names within this house? Who is this Skelly, and what do you presume is the connection that exists between us?
Well, essentially, he's an animated skeleton who shows up just outside my bedchambers and lets me practice with my weapons on him. I sort of figured that you put him up to it.
Achilles moves throughout these chambers under my own shroud, if you must know. And thus you have in your possession the infernal arms. But I have not exerted further influence than that. Is this skeleton to be trusted, then?
I think so. I don't know. He seems all right.